Hi YouTube, I'm Tracy Cox and welcome to Sex Talk. Now loads of you have been asking me about same-sex encounters, so I thought the Straight Girl's Guide to Sex with a Woman might help with some of those burning questions. For more Sex Talk, don't forget to subscribe to Body Talk. So, by curiosity, women sleeping with women simply because they want to know what it's like. Now this is becoming more and more commonplace and very in to admit. Fergie, Pink, Drew Barrymore, Lindsay Lohan, Jodie Marsh, Lady Gaga, they've all openly admitted to having lesbian flingettes. And every sane woman in the entire world puts her hand up and says, yes please, when asked if they'd like to take a girly tumble with the straight girl's fantasy queen, Angelina Jolie. Now, sex guru Kinsey claimed that by the age of 30, one woman in four had felt sexually attracted to another woman. By age 40, he said, one in five had experimented with the same sex. Recent reliable statistics are pretty hard to come by. On one hand, you've got celebrities falling over themselves to admit to bi-curious encounters. On the other, you have normal women who are too shy to confess. Now, in my experience of writing and researching sex and through talking with lesbian friends, I consider Kinsey's estimates to be way too low. I know lots of straight women who've not only had some pretty hot fantasies, they claim they'd act on them if the situation arose. Reading between the lines, I'm guessing a few of them already actually have. So I figured if they're thinking about it, chances are lots of you are too, and perhaps it would be a good idea to talk through what might happen in reality. So here you go. This is a first-timer's guide to sleeping with a woman, compiled and approved by a selection of bi-curious, bisexual, and lesbian women.
It would be a lot more sensual, sensitive, experimental, I guess, a lot different.
Body shape, body size.
I think with a man, they know what they want and it kind of go down a particular path.
Well, the first thing you'll probably notice is how soft and smooth women feel. Doing it to someone who has what you've got feels strange, but it's also comforting. You feel like you've got a bit of a head start compared to the first time you slept with a man. Now, when you're touching or licking her, knowing what it would feel like if it was being done to you is an erotic extra. Like gay men, you'll notice women with women switch sexual roles much more than straight couples do. You'll tend not to split into giver and taker, you both take turns. Because women take longer to orgasm than men do, you may find women are more patient and you feel less pressure to hurry up and have an orgasm. One woman said it felt incredibly safe. Oh, and you can both have lots of orgasms rather than just one, so there's no definite ending to a sex session. Straight sex tends to be geared towards penetration and often ends with one orgasm, unfortunately his. Lesbian sex sessions are less predictable and organic. Well, if you've got lesbian girlfriends, simply tag along with them to a lesbian bar or go with a straight girl who's happy to come with you. As for who to approach, the kind of lesbian you pick is probably going to determine what kind of experience you have. One girl told me if you go for someone very femme, you're probably going to have a soft, girly, feminine sort of experience, a bit like sleeping with one of your girlfriends, only more experienced. She recommends actually sleeping with somebody who's quite butch the first time round. She said the butch girls might look scary, but they usually aren't, and if you don't know what to do, they're likely to take charge. Often, they don't expect you to reciprocate, so if you're a little bit squeamish when it comes to the going down on a girl part, this can be a good thing. If you don't like the idea of going to a bar, you could go online and check out a lesbian dating site like gaydargirls.com, or check out online magazines like G3 Mag or Diva Mag and see what events are on near you. Both are used by straight women who want to hook up with a lesbian. Or you could just hang around those lesbian friends of yours for a bit and see who you happen to be introduced to. Go with what feels comfortable.
I think lesbian women would like to sleep with straight women. I think it's something experimental for them, and I guess we never know what we like until we try it.
There'd be no barriers really in a sense, like straight women. I think they'd be quite interested, I think.
Everyone wants to experiment and nothing wrong with that.
This is an interesting one. While lots of gay men say they fantasize about sex with a straight guy, women aren't so keen, to the point where three of the straight girls I interviewed had to lie to get laid for the first time with a woman. One lesbian friend said all the lesbian girls she knew had absolutely no interest in straight women because the ones who do inevitably end up with their hearts broken. Another friend said she wouldn't go there with a barge pole. She said they'd have to be super hot for her to take the risk. She said most straight women won't come right out and say it is just an experiment. And even if they do, it's usually a one-off and they're likely to go back to their boyfriends. Or if they like it and discover they're lesbian, they want to experiment with other women. And either way, you can't really win. You don't ever want to be anyone's first was something I heard over and over. Others were more worried about breaking her heart. Said one lesbian, women are so clingy and needy, and once you've blown their minds, and you do, because let's face it, lesbian sex is the best sex out there, she's going to be all emotional and you're never going to get rid of her. Which leaves you in a bit of a spot. If you take the advice of the people I've spoken to, you wouldn't admit it's your first time. You may have to lie, in other words, which some of you may not be prepared to do. Now, the alternative is to simply say nothing, and if they bring up the topic, say, I'm kind of shy talking about sex. But I'll leave that particular moral dilemma up to you.
Definitely. I think if like a straight woman wants to experiment with a lesbian, then she should definitely let her know.
People like in this society, are, like the young people are more open about it now.
If you're bi curious, I think if she knows that from the start of the relationship or the friendship, then that's fine.
And they should always be honest about it. They should obviously explain how they feel and that they're curious. Maybe not to be like lying to the other person and just let them know so they're not getting too involved. They're just experimenting and seeing how they feel about it.
I don't think there's anything wrong with that. I mean, leading someone on is probably not very nice, but as long as you're on the same and you understand the same terms, then I think there's nothing wrong with it, to be honest.
Again, it's a damned if you do, damned if you don't thing. Most of the girls I spoke to said, of course you should tell, but that also might mean they don't go there. Straight women I spoke to said they would confess to a woman it was more of a curiosity thing than likely to lead to love. Interestingly, the same woman who had no qualms whatsoever using a guy just for sex without mentioning a word. Why think twice when it's sex with a woman? Well, it's because we perceive women to attach more feelings to sex than men do. And this is quite right in a lot of cases. But anyone who's ever tuned into The L Word, which was a show about lesbians that was hugely popular a while back, and watched Shane attach her lips and hips to around 10 women a week, knows there are women out there who will be very happy to love you and leave you. I just sometimes fancy someone and want to have sex with that person, whether she's lesbian or straight, said one girl. And if she's quite an alpha female with men, she's probably going to be good in bed with a girl.
I don't know, I'd assume it's the same way you approach a man.
It would be a bit more like about talking and then like maybe like nice eye contact and stuff like that. I don't think I would talk about it or even suggest it. I think it just kind of comes around and happens.
Go up to them and say, do you want to go to bed with me?
Flirt a bit, touch a little longer and more sexually than you would usually, stand close, make lots of eye contact, and hang on, isn't this sounding a bit familiar? Dead right, it's the same way you'd show interest to a man, except unlike with a man, if she knows you're straight, you're probably going to have to make all of the moves. Now, a common comment from gay girls was this one. I'd flirt a little to test the water, but I'd let her make the definitive move. I wouldn't want to push her, misread the situation, or be blamed for taking advantage of a weak moment. So it's up to you to make it clear what you want, in other words. But if you fancy someone in a bar, it's late, they've had more than a few, and there seems to be lots of snogging going on, she may assume you're lesbian and move in for the kill. So if you're going to be shocked by a possible forward approach, and by that I mean a tongue in your mouth and hand up your jumper, best speak up fairly early on. Just say something like, hi, I'm new to all this. Seems like fun though.
It's a completely different type of intercourse, so they would definitely be able to tell.
Possibly. It depends how talented you are, really.
Five of the girls I interviewed said they pretended to be experienced with their first female lover and they got away with it, so it can be done. If you like sex generally and you're quite into the situation, it probably won't be a problem. So long as you're adventurous and assertive, most women probably wouldn't be able to tell if you're a virgin, but they might well figure it out afterward. A lot of women said they spot it immediately by your emotional reaction. First timers often get quite over emotional after the sex is over. Worried about how you perform? don't commit the classic first timer's mistake of assuming you'll know exactly what she likes just because she's got what you've got. It does make it easier, but we're all individual, and what makes your eyes roll back in ecstasy could make hers roll to the ceiling in actual boredom or frustration. On the other hand, if you're stuck for inspiration, think about what turns you on. After all that's happening is you're on a different side to all the techniques guys used on you. Now, if you're really nervous, simply say, "I don't know what to do, will you take charge?" and then lie back and enjoy, though not for a long time. Lazy girls aren't a huge hit with lesbians. Practice makes perfect, but it wouldn't hurt to read up a little on the topic of lesbian sex. Simply choose from one of the many excellent books available, but don't get too caught up in needing to be good in bed. As the saying goes, sex is perfectly natural. It is not naturally perfect.
Go down on each other, maybe? Obviously, it's a bit harder than the usual intercourse, but I guess they go down on each other. They use different sex tools.
I don't think it's as straightforward as just oral sex.
And there's lots of toys and things like there, and there's lots more that you can do. I don't think it's just specific to oral sex at all.
Don't make the assumption that all lesbians are into oral sex. True, some only do just that, because for some lesbians, penetration is taboo as it's seen as so male. But there are lots of lesbians who love either penetrating with a strap-on or being penetrated. A lot of lesbians have a variety of sizes and strap-on penises because they feel like different things on different days, and feel quite sorry for straight women who are stuck with a man who has the same size penis every day. If you end up back at her place, you may find yourself spoiled for choice. Now, one tip: if she asks you to use a strap-on on her and you haven't done it before, confess. Apparently, it takes practice to get the hang of. Now, some lesbians like to use strap-ons for anal sex as well. Now, while the incidence of sexually transmitted infections are lower with lesbians, you still need to practice safe sex, which means pop a condom over any sex toys. Other stuff that might be on the cards? Obvious things like kissing, lots of breast play, but also scissoring, which simply means rubbing your crotch up against each other.
Not necessarily. They could be bisexual, they could be straight, they could just be experimenting or possibly having fun. I don't think sexuality is really that straightforward.
I think it's more of an emotional status and how we feel about the other person.
I don't think that someone's 100% gay and 100% lesbian. I think there's always a grey area, so to speak.
I think it's about being adventurous and about trying out things and exploring sex, but I don't think it necessarily makes you a lesbian.
Almost all of the women I spoke with said you know if you're lesbian the second you sleep with a woman. It's an entirely different feeling than simply enjoying it. Some women insist occasional lesbians are in denial, but lots agree there are women who are mainly straight but just enjoy the odd dabble. You probably will think about it a lot though, either way. Just as your first time with a man affects you deeply, so does your first time with a woman. You might feel guilty if you cheated on a boyfriend, or weird if you actually did quite like it. If you liked it more than you like sex with men, or you felt a sense of relief, or like you'd sort of come home, you might want to explore your sexuality a little further. Check out some books or websites that detail lesbian coming out stories and just see if you identify with them. There's lots of support if you do decide you're lesbian. Search for lesbian support groups online and you'll find there are plenty. Though, having said that, most women who have a same-sex encounter because they're curious simply enjoy it for what it was, a healthy exploration of sex. I hope this has helped make your adventure more enjoyable, and I hope you've enjoyed today's sex talk. Look forward to seeing you next time. Sex is smelly, noisy, sweaty, and unflattering. And if you've never done anything in bed that's caused you the slightest bit of embarrassment, you win the award for the world's most boring lover. The world's best has had semen in their eye, pubic hair up their nose, broken wind at the worst possible moment,